What's up, family? It's Vusi Max here with another analysis video for the first week of June. So right off the bat, can you guys like believe how half of the year just went by just like that? So if you've been slacking on the trading, then like I feel like you should really take this as a wake-up call or motivation to kind of like step up your game, you know. So before we get started with this video, I want to address something real quick. At the moment I'm in Durban, right? So the place where I was staying for the course of the weekend, I don't know what happened, but the power just like went off this morning. And me being me, I forgot to charge my phone, so I had to like get out, go to the nearest McDonald's, which is where I'm at right now, right? So there's they're playing some romantic music in the background. So like I'm gonna try to make this video as short, not as short as possible, but I'm gonna try to make the video not too long, right? Because I know there's gonna be some romantic music like in my background and stuff. So all right, let's get right into it, like right now. Okay, so like the last pay I was looking at this past week was the US dollar Japanese yen. This pair was providing such a nice downtrend, and what I favored with this is the fact that I could draw the whole trend without having to zoom out and go to like 2 months back or stuff like that. It just fits to the screen when I put it in the landscape. So my supreme family knows the standard procedure for like when it comes to spotting trends. So we know this is a downtrend, and we had the first reversal right there on the 24th of May, and then we had another breakout on the 30th of May, right? But this was kind of like one trade. Let me show you what I mean when I say this was one trade. I'm gonna move this here, and I'm gonna move this here. Yeah, so the first reversal we had there broke out here, and my team knows that as soon as we cross reversal, the SL goes to the high, the SL and the TP go to the highs and lows, right? So we sold, and then we didn't hit SL, we didn't hit TP here, but we were still dipping to profits. And then we started another reversal, which made another lower high, which was like, this was a sign that we're still trending downwards on this pair. So this was either an opportunity to sell again and move your SL from the initial point to the second lower high, and then that's when we hit TP. So I just wanted to make a recap for the members, right? So the next pair I have is Euro USD. So the Euro USD is one I'm looking forward to this coming week, right? Because when you have this screen in landscape, we can see that starting from here, we have a high, a lower high, we have a low, and not necessarily a lower low, but for the mere fact that where price is at the moment is still beneath the previous high, that means we're still in a trend, right? So what we're looking to do here is draw a trend line like so, and then have our reversal line like so. like so. Yeah, we'll have our reversal line in this manner. So you know that we only wait for reversal line cross and targets will be up until this point, and hopefully we'll get to look at this in the 4-hour time frame. We're only looking at this in the 4-hour time frame. All right, so we have the Euro USD. The USD against the Danish krone. I think this pair is called the Danish krone. Correct me if I'm wrong. So this is an exotic pair right off the bat, right? So keep in mind, before you trade this one, the spread will be a bit higher than the major pairs and the minor pairs. And the reason I even included the exotic pairs was because there wasn't really, okay, there was trends in the majors and minors, but the trends at the moment, they already took off. They're not in a reversal state, so that's the reason. But that just, like, to me, that just tells me that in the following week we'll get to see more reversals, or we might even start to see reversals this week. So that means we'll have more trades on our watch list on the coming week, right? So for now, I had to go and look at the exotic pairs, because we have to trade, you know what I'm saying? We still have to trade. So just mind your lot size, because these pairs have a higher volatility rate than the major pairs and the minor pairs. So this is an uptrend from where I'm seeing it. We have a low, a higher low, we have a higher and a higher high in terms of the candle close, right? So this is how it looks right off the bat. And we know that since it's going against the trend, that means that's our reversal. So we'll have our reversal line here, and then provided that the next low is a higher low, that's going to be the opportunity for us to buy. Alternatively, we're gonna buy when you see a reversal line cross. Okay, targets will be up to this point, up to the candle close of the recent high. All right, then we have, last but not least, we have the USD against the South African rand. Okay, so looking at this pair, the analysis, let's draw the trend line first. Let's define the trend. So the trend line is like this now, right? So the trend line is like this at the moment. It's been having a low, a high, higher low, and a higher high right there. All right. So I'm expecting this to go and have a bounce somewhere in this region. This might go and touch the trend line first before we see the bounce to make a higher high, but if we might get a reversal cross before we even get to see the candlesticks approach the trend line. Because I want to see just what's going on here. We'll see. I'm drawing this line to see if there's any correlation between these points, but it doesn't matter, because either way, if we draw our reversal line, I'm gonna put it just like that. If we draw a reversal line like this, then we'll just have to wait for the candlesticks to cross the reversal line, provided it's still a higher low than that. And our targets are going to be somewhere at this region. This is where we'll have our targets for the next region. So that wraps the analysis, guys. I hope it's not too long. And before I close this off, I would like to send a shout out to our new student, Njabulo. Njabulo, I hope I'm saying it right. Yeah, it's Njabulo. His name is Njabulo. So, Njabulo sent this pay, the USD against the Danish krone, and upon looking at it, I thought it was an excellent pay. So it just got me excited to even see the young king student. I mean, the young king's results, as the time goes, I know for a fact it's gonna do something, right? So that's it for this coming week's thing. That's it for this coming week's watch list. Although I'm interested to see the members' analysis also, because as I was going through this, like I said, most of the major pairs and the minor pairs, I found them to be in a breakout and not in a reversal, right? So that's why we have some of the exotic pairs on this one. So have an awesome trading week, guys, and I'll see you on the next one. Cheers.